Hello and welcome to News Warrior, BharatShakti.in's own video blog. I am Nitin Gokhale. Today we are going to talk about India's island territories, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands on the eastern seaboard and the Lakshadweep and Minicoy Islands on the western seaboard. These island territories far off from India's mainland, in fact as far as 1200 nautical miles from Chennai to Port Blair is the distance that Andaman's capital Port Blair is, and really farther than any other capital, and therefore out of sight has been out of mind as far as Andaman Nicobar Islands or Lakshadweep and Minicoy are concerned. But all that is about to change. After years of neglect and apathy by the central government, despite an island development authority that was set up in 1986, bypass these group of islands. Remember, Andaman and Nicobar group of islands consist of 572 islands north to south, which is about 450 nautical miles in distance. But only about 30 odd islands in that group of islands are inhabited and where people have been going and coming. Rest of the islands have been completely barren, and that's where the government now wants to develop and utilize that landmass, which is closer to Southeast Asia than the Indian mainland really. I'm talking about the Andaman Nicobar Islands first before we go to Lakshadweep and Minicoy. So what is in store? In June 2017, Centre set up a new body called the Island Development Agency, headed by Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh, and the number two in that agency is the Lieutenant Governor of Andaman and Nicobar and former Navy Chief Admiral D.K. Joshi. He is the executive authority in that sense of the Island Development Agency. Island Development Agency has been entrusted with all-round development of India's island territories. And to begin with, the body consists of very high profile secretaries of various ministries including home, defense, environment, civil aviation, mining, also road transport, all these and shipping. All these secretaries are in that same agency that has been set up for a comprehensive development of these islands. And there the Niti Aayog has also been entrusted with making plans. So after due deliberations in the last 3 or 4 months, comprehensive all-round plans have been made for development of these islands there. And one of the main highlights of the development plan is to extend and make new airports and extend the runways of the old airfields that are available in the Andaman Nicobar group of islands. So starting from Diglipur in the north, which is closer to Myanmar than India, Myanmar's Koko Island is just 10 nautical miles away from Diglipur, and coming down to Port Blair in the middle Andamans, coming after that further south to Campbell Bay, and then at Kar Nicobar, these four airfields are now going to be of a length of nearly 3.2 kilometers instead of 1 kilometer that the current runways are. What it means is bigger aircraft, both for military and civil purposes, can now land at these airfields in the coming years. The contracts are being awarded in the next couple of months. Land has already been allotted, and Airports Authority of India have started work on extending these airfields. This also means that charter planes for tourists can come in, and tourists can come in large numbers, foreign tourists can come in large numbers in Andaman and Nicobar, because the old restricted area permit, which was restrictive in its nature, has been done away with except for some strategically located islands. So now foreigners can come freely and go back, or maybe even take a stopover in Andaman and Nicobar and then go further down to Phuket, which is just 750 nautical miles from Port Blair, or go to Bangkok if the connectivity is established. So in a way, Andaman and Nicobar is now going to be the springboard for India's Act East policy, both in terms of tourism, trade, development, and of course the military aspect, which I will speak about in the next part. But as far as the civil aspects are concerned, the government of Andaman and even the central government is now exploring possibility of having direct trade between ASEAN countries and Andaman and Nicobar Islands, land customs post, other facilities required for international trade are being set up there. 4 mega tourist complex are being set up on a PPP model, that is the public-private partnership model, in Andamans. In coming months, the contracts will be awarded. So connectivity, tourism development, more jobs for the locals, and of course digital connectivity, all that is being thought about and executed by one central agency called the Island Development Agency. Coming to Minicoy and Lakshadweep, similar 4 mega tourism complexes are coming up there on a PPP model. The expression of interest have already happened, pre-bid meetings have happened, and 4 contracts will be awarded by end of December 2018 in those islands. Minicoy airfield is also being extended similarly, like it is being done with the Andaman and Nicobar airstrips, which will give India a strategic advantage in the Indian Ocean. Minicoy is, the tip of Minicoy Island is just 80 nautical miles north of Maldives, and therefore you can understand the importance of Minicoy Island. The Lakshadweep administration is also looking for more and more flights coming into the islands there. There is a naval base already established in one of the islands in Minicoy and Lakshadweep. Similarly, of course, Andaman has several plans for the naval and the Air Force aspects of it, which we will talk about, as I said, in the second part. But all in all, there is a focused attention on developing the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, as well as Lakshadweep and Minicoy, mainly because India has realized the importance and the strategic location of these islands, sitting astride as they are on the busy sea lanes of communication, which comes through the Malacca Straits. In fact, the tip of Nicobar Islands at Indira Point is just about 80 nautical miles from the western edge of Malacca Straits, which is an important sea lane of communication. And therefore, many plans are now afoot to give a renewed focus to development of these areas for both military and civil purposes. So that's something that we should watch out for. It is going to be a major tourist hub. It's going to be a major military base for India's military in coming years. And of course, the importance of Andaman and Nicobar Islands as an unsinkable aircraft carrier, as described by none other than a Chinese strategic expert, will be now evident in coming years. So on that note, this is Nitin Gokhale signing off. But keep sending your emails, your comments, your feedback, and let us know if we can do something more on this program. Until the next time, it's goodbye and good luck.